Good afternoon. Out there on launch pad, an American Apollo is poised to go in just 20 minutes. Just 7 hours ago, half a world away from here, a flawless launch of a Soviet Soyuz got the first joint venture in space off to a challenging start. The American astronauts, Tom Stafford, Deke Slayton, and Vance Brand, already have sent ahead congratulations on their launch to the two cosmonauts, Alexei Leonov and Valery Kubasov, with whom they will share an unprecedented international meeting in space.
I know Alexei as my brother.
We all got a job to do. We've got to work together to do it right. And I think we're all going to be working together to do that.
Cooperation means friendship. Friendship means peace.
This is a CBS News special report. Apollo-Soyuz, a meeting in space. This broadcast is sponsored by Weiler Foods, Borden Incorporated, makers of Weiler's soft drink mixes, and by Johnson Wax, makers of Shout, the heavy-duty stain remover specially made to get the tough stains out.
First stage, second stage, and instrument unit now on internal power. Approaching the 30-second mark in our countdown, water pouring onto the flame deflector, now coming onto the deck of the mobile launcher. Everything proceeding smoothly. We'll get a guidance release at the 17-second mark.
20 seconds.
The engines will actually start. The engine sequence starts at 3.1 seconds in the countdown. We'll hold down till thrust builds up.
11.
Engine 10, ready light on.
9,
10, 9,
8,
7,
6,
5,
4,
3,
2,
engine sequence start.
1, 0,
launch commit. We have a liftoff. All engines building up thrust. Moving out. Clear the tower.
Oh, it's a good bird. Oh, that's a great machine. Takes me back a few years, but my gosh, you're leaving here in a hurry.
Can't do any better than that.
No, not really.
Maybe you could get married today and we'll go on the honeymoon tonight. Congratulations. Ed McNeil, 67 Floyd Street in Everett. Let's watch the replay of it and watch him go. $2,200, and we'll have a chance to watch the replay. Here it comes. Will you see it? Look out. There they go. It is the jackpot! Bill and Flynn and Ed McNeil of Everett. $2,200. All right, the last pin to go over there was the 7-pin, and was it exciting? But we're not finished. We're not finished. You got to go up there and go for an automobile now. Incidentally, the merchandise prize, you also win a new stereo set. You get a stereo in addition to the $2,200, and there it is. That is today's merchandise prize. So one goes for you, and the other one goes for Ed McNeil of Everett. And now we're going to go for the super jackpot. You understand on this one, if you bowl another strike, you win an automobile. Your pin pal wins an automobile. And if you bowl a spare, it's an extra $500 split between you and the pin pal. Good luck. Let's send them off as we go for the super jackpot. Bill Donahue of Lynn. Here we go. Look out. Look out. He's in. Another one. I don't believe it. He's lit again. How do you like it? There goes the gremlin car. There goes everything.
Let me go bowl another one.
He wants to go back. He wants to go up and bowl another one. Now that's it. We're wiped out of prizes. You got everything. The stereo, the car, and the jackpot. Let's see if we can see that replay again. That was an incredible one. Just as good as the first one, and no doubt about it. I don't believe it. We've given away two more cars from Bach Motors. We're taking them to the cleaners. Okay, let's see. Look out. Look out again! He's in! Another one! I don't believe it!
And now only the lifting of the Apollo spacecraft onto the carrier deck remains to bring to a successful end an era of space exploration. This is the last Apollo flight, and barring unforeseen developments, Wally, the last parachute landing of an American spacecraft. When the shuttle spacecraft are introduced in 79 or 80, Americans will be landing their spacecraft like airplanes, and the era of exploitation instead of exploration of space will be underway. Man will be well on his way toward the inhabitable space stations of the future. Through the test flights of Mercury and Gemini and the moon flights and experimental space stations of Skylab, there have now been 31 American manned space missions. 43 Americans have flown into space, 17 of them more than once since Alan Shepard's first 15-minute ride 14 years ago, Wally Schirra three times. Almost 500,000 persons worked on the space program at its peak years, and the manned flights alone fed around $27 billion into the economy. The cost also included three lives, the original Apollo astronauts who died when their spacecraft burned on the pad. Probably only history will be able to judge whether the expenditure was worth the gain, but history must record that this was the generation of Americans that conquered space, first put man on the moon, and opened for future exploration horizons as distant as the planets. This is Walter Cronkite speaking for Wally Schirra and the entire CBS News space team. Good evening.
This has been a CBS News special report. Apollo-Soyuz, a meeting in space. This broadcast was sponsored by Lum's Restaurants all over America. Lum's, no one else will give you more. And by Johnson Wax, makers of new Glade Solid air freshener.
The following videotape program features highlights from recent Good Morning shows. Welcome to Good Morning Sunday.
Welcome to Good Morning Sunday. I'm John Willis. Janet Langhart is on vacation today. And those are some of the folks who dropped by Good Morning over the past week or so. Next week, joining us on the regular edition of Good Morning, Monday through Friday, live, 9 to 10:30, if you haven't joined us, will be the world-famed concert pianist, Lauren Hollander. We're going to have sportscaster, Dandy Don Meredith. I wonder if I say that in prison when he's here. Also, we're going to have attorney Fred Thompson, who was involved, very much involved, with the Senate Watergate hearings. We're going to have underwater photography from the National Geographic magazine. And jazz. Here's the piece de resistance. Jazz with Earl Father Hines. So those are just some of the people who'll be dropping by. We hope you will. Janet was off today. She'll be back tomorrow morning. Won't you join us for Good Morning?
Good evening. Welcome to our unrehearsed, spontaneous, and informal program. As always, no teleprompters, no cue cards. We normally say no reruns, but this is a different night, and we'll tell you about it in a moment. Just plain ad-lib conversation. With me, as always, is my dear wife, Jackie.
Good evening. If you have a question that you would like me to ask Lou or a comment about the show, then write to us. The address is Lou Gordon, Box 700, Detroit, Michigan. Lou, who are the guests tonight?
I said I eliminated the word no reruns from a normal introduction because we are going to show you some reruns tonight. We're going to show you three interviews which we've done in the past, which are highly unusual, and many people have requested to see again from time to time. One involves a gentleman who calls himself Joey the Hitman, a paid killer who wears a mask, says he's murdered over 40 people for cash. Rachel Harlow, the world's most beautiful transsexual. And if you look at this woman and can believe that she once was a man, I think you'll find it the most startling experience you've had in a long time. And the Reverend Liston Pack, who proves his faith in God by handling poisonous snakes right here in the studio. And I remember him dancing with that snake when he was in a trance and putting it up close to my nose. And I remember me almost fading off the back of the chair. All right, Jackie, let's take some questions.
Oh,
who,
yes.
Who thinks that this is all being kept from us? They have those six frozen bodies or something, and
yeah,
they're
12 or
cutting
something.
Them up or whatever, or what, I don't know. We have time for one more question, I think. Check
well, one. I don't know whether I have one more question to ask you.
All right, then we won't take any more questions. And we'll just say that we'll be back next week, and we hope you'll be with us. And among our guests we hope to have next week will be H.R. Bob Haldeman, Muhammad Ali, and some other surprises. And we'll have some comments on your questions, and be sure to send those questions to Box 700, Detroit, Michigan, and make them as tough as you want to and as personal as you want to, because you throw the fastballs and I'll answer them just as fast, I hope. Thank you for watching. Good night. Good luck.
Good night.
The opinions expressed are those of the participants and Lou Gordon and do not necessarily reflect the views of this station or Kaiser Broadcasting. The Lou Gordon Program is a news and public affairs presentation of Kaiser Broadcasting. This program was pre-recorded.
Well, that's Eyewitness News. We'll be back with an abbreviated newscast during halftime of the Miami-Buffalo football game. Until then, for the entire Eyewitness News team, I'm Jack Borden.
Wake up with the morning team. News with Gary LaPierre, Don Kent's weather, Gil Santos on sports, traffic with Joe Green, Pat Mitchell's reports, and music with Carl DeSues and Dave Maynard. Weekdays on BZ Radio 103.
We've run out of time, but I promise you next week we'll provide more time for comments on your questions. And remember, the box is 700 and write to us and we'll try and do what we can. Next week we have two interesting guests, Shirley Barish, who is television's top headhunter. She provides anchor persons, anchor men, anchor women for TV news shows. She'll tell us what television stations are looking for when they hire these people. She says they want young male studs with 10 years of experience, among other things, and we'll ask her opinion of the news as it is now being given on local stations. We'll talk to psychiatrist Dr. David Viscott, who many of you may have seen on the Johnny Carson show, but I assure you this will be a different kind of interview. He's the first doctor to have said publicly that Richard Nixon was insane before he left the presidency, and we'll certainly ask him why. We hope you'll be with us next week. We thank you for watching. Good night. Good luck.
Good night.
Opinions expressed are those of the participants and Lou Gordon and do not necessarily reflect the views of this station or Kaiser Broadcasting. Gordon Program is a news and public affairs presentation of Kaiser Broadcasting. This program was pre-recorded.
Good evening. In the headlines tonight, this nation celebrated its 200th birthday today in grand style.
And a bomb exploded at the First National Bank in Revere. We'll have details coming up in just a moment.
Try your hand at art in a summer theme workshop.
Good evening, I'm Marilyn Salenger.
And I'm Steve Shepard. And in the headlines tonight, the FBI arrested two Maine men today after discovering 46 sticks of dynamite in a car. The entire United States celebrates its 200th birthday. And the Red Sox break into the win column with a 3-1 victory over Milwaukee. All part of what you'll see tonight on Newsroom 7.
This is Newsroom 7 with Steve Shepard and Marilyn Salenger, Roy Reese on sports, and Dr. Fred with the weather. Now, Steve Shepard.
Vivacious, funny, and lovely. Sandy Duncan is Dinah's special guest tomorrow night at 8:30 on Channel 56.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Dave Diles, and once again, I'm filling in for Lou Gordon, and we're delighted to report to you that Lou is making remarkable progress after a bout with pneumonia. He'll be back on the program very shortly. Evening, and I hope it's been the same for you. As we mentioned, Lou Gordon will be back next week, and Jackie, you'll be alongside of him, as is your custom, and you have some interesting people next week also.
Yes, certainly do. He will be here, and he'll be here to answer your questions. So, for heaven's sakes, those questions you've been saving for Lou to ask, send them to us. Right. The address is Lou Gordon, Box 700, Detroit, Michigan. And Lou's guest next week will be Philip Hodson, sort of a neat guy, executive editor of Penthouse Forum magazine, and Robert Dornan, another neat guy, spokesman for Citizens for Decency Through Law, who will debate whether how-to sex books are destroying the American family and the morality of the country. Now, this has been pre-taped. I've seen it. It's a very interesting interview. I think you'll find it interesting, too. So, remember, the address is Box 700, Detroit, Michigan. Lou Gordon, for the questions that you would like Lou to answer. David?
I always worry about people who need how-to books on subjects like that. Jackie, thanks very much. And,
oh, well, let me thank you again.
Thank you for your kindness over the past few weeks. And somewhere along the line, we'll be seeing you again. And again, stay tuned for Lou Gordon each and every week right here. Okay? Good night.
Good night.
A news and public affairs presentation of Kaiser Broadcasting. This program was pre-recorded.
Dear sir, I read where your station had purchased Channel 5 sports film library. Will you be showing some of this old footage prior to the baseball season to whet our appetites? If so, please no 67 World Series. I'm bored to death with it. Would love to see some other things, though.
No, we're not going to be using it prior to this baseball season. We may be using some of it during the season, like an arena out or between doubleheaders. We really don't know as yet. It's such a massive library, really. It's going to probably take, 6 to 8 months to just put it together and to find out what you have, what you finally really have, what's usable, and so forth. We'll be using bits and pieces of it during this season, but it won't get very, really extensive use, I'd say, for 6 to 8 months.
It's about 3 million feet of film alone in that.
Yeah, see, 3 million feet of film, plus all the videotapes, and it's a massive library.
It's quite
incredible.
Extensive.
I don't think any station in the country Literally, I don't think any other station in the country had done such a... For example, might be of interest, because I was stunned when I heard this, but as you know, the old Channel 5, WHDH, were the call letters, and they were doing the Red Sox on television as well as on radio. But they shot, WHDH shot every game in film as well as on tape. I mean, they were televising the game live, but they're shooting it on film, too. It's that kind of a, it's an incredible library. Okay, we're back, and there's the address again. So, really, you write your letters. And we were all sitting here laughing because they said, I hope you don't get another time zone question because no one knows what you said or what the question was. But anyhow, you go ahead and write, and we'll stumble through another one. Really, though, about our station or about the television here in the city or just generally. We'd like to hear from you, and we hope to see you next Sunday, whatever time we are on. They keep moving this show all over the place, and so we never know when we're going to appear, when we aren't going to appear, but we enjoy having you, and we hope you enjoy having us, and I'm stalling till I get a signal, and we're
remember
out
this.
Of time. Oh, now I guess. So, okay, fine. We stretched it, Gino.
Good.
Thank you all. We'll see you next week. Good night.
Our entire program, with the exception of questions and answers, will be devoted to the Kennedy assassination. Who really pulled the trigger? We'll take an in-depth look at that dreadful event with three men who have studied it at length. We'll show a clearer version of the famous Zapruder film, the first time ever seen on TV. And incidentally, Tom Snyder couldn't get the film to show on his tomorrow program. And Albert Jenner will be here, the senior counsel of the Warren Commission, and the Republican counsel to the House Impeachment Committee on Nixon, and he'll study the evidence with me, and you'll all be able to draw your own conclusions as to what really happened in Dallas on that fateful day, and I'll tell you what I think about it after the evidence has been presented, as if you care what I really think. Hope we'll see you next week. Thank you for watching. Good night. Good luck.
Good night.
Opinions expressed are those of the participants and Lou Gordon and do not necessarily reflect the views of this station or Kaiser Broadcasting.
Across this United States, and what a great job they all did that work, and they deserve, I think we would all agree, a great deal of credit. The names you see usually at the end of a broadcast are television's way of saying thanks to the people who made the broadcast possible, too. And what great work our CBS News team did today. Hundreds of technical and editorial people worked on this broadcast, and that gives me a little bit of a problem. This has been a most unusual day. We don't want to put hundreds of names on the screen. We'd be sitting here till tomorrow morning. But I personally thank, I'm sure for you, every person who worked on this broadcast here in New York, all over the country and overseas too. Each of them had responsibilities that made this whole effort work. Well, the party's just about over. We're 200 years old. It's a milestone that makes us wonder what will become of us as a nation. We're not sure of the future. No one can be. We don't know what's behind the doors that we must open. We only know that the keys we have, keys cut in Independence Hall, which became our ideals, liberty, justice, equality. Our people have suffered and died for those ideals. We have, as a nation, written a remarkable history, certainly. But we should remember that we have not fulfilled our ideals even after 200 years. Correcting wrongs will be part of our future. It will demand courage. But correcting wrongs has been a dramatic part of our history. Courage is a remarkable part of our heritage. It can open the doors to justice for everyone. We'll be all right if we keep in our hearts the story of America. If we do, well, then 100 years from now, our country's hearts will still be host to those ideals that we gave the world on July 4th, 1776. And that's the way it is, July 4th, 1976. This is Walter Cronkite, CBS News. Good night and happy birthday.
Enjoy the glittering pageant as 70 beautiful girls compete for the crown and scepter of Miss Universe Saturday night on CBS.